Say anybody about to make it to say? Please come in.
Good evening.
15 minutes.
At the outset, I should thank the IMA Kodambakkam branch for giving me the opportunity to talk on this battered baby child. Before talking, I thought I will show you next slide. I really thank the IMA Chennai Kodambakkam for recommending my name for this Academic Excellence Award in 2019, 12th July. Next. So I received this Academic Excellence Award. Thank the President, Secretary, Treasurer and the EC members, each and every member of IMA Chennai Kodambakkam. It's a proud moment for me because this is the, one of the achievements which I received. Next. Coming to the topic, this emergency radiology in battered baby child. See, I just wanted to keep an awareness because every time we are thinking it is a Western population only is having. Because both the husband and wife are going for a work, leaving the child to the servant lady or the whoever the caretaker. But in the emergency radiology, we started seeing a lot of this battered baby child. Next. In India, this non-accidental injury is common. But we don't have that much of statistics to prove that this is a battered baby syndrome. But as you all know, the media and also all the papers is saying that child abuse is rampant. Cruelty on children at an alarming rate in India, north or east or west or in the south. Child abuse is more prevalent in metropolitan cities and urban sectors than in rural areas of the country. Next. Just to create an awareness, I'm not going to teach you how to diagnose this and all, but just for the create an awareness. It's a child abuse is a portion of harm to the children that results from human action. Next. So there are four major categories of child abuse. One is a neglect. Second one is a physical abuse and a emotional abuse and a sexual abuse. All these are all, you are all very well known. In your practice also you'll be seeing that. Next. As a diagnostic immunologist, there is a threefold. One is to recognize the characteristic lesions of the physical abuse to support diagnosis or raise a suspicion. Because the usual fall from a cart or prior injury, that will have a different injury, but battered child will have a different injury. Serve as a evidence of a mechanism and pattern of healing of injury in a court of law. See the shaken baby. When the child is old and then shaken, their ribs will be fractured or the head will be hemorrhaging there. I'll show you that one. May help to exclude the diagnosis of a child. Next. Burning. This is also, it has come in the Times of India. Burning a baby may be a victim of abuse. Next. This is what? There are different terminology for this. Child abuse, battered child syndrome, shaken baby or the infant syndrome, stress-related infant abuse, non-accidental trauma. So all these are all categorized into that battered baby child. Next. Most common cause is the intracranial injury. Because when constantly the child is crying, they will hold the baby and then shake. So that causes the intracranial injury. And the third most common cause of death in children after a sudden infant death syndrome and true accidents and skeletal trauma. Any part of the skeletal will be affected and the age is usually less than 2 years. Next. Statistics. This is what the statistics for the neglect, physical abuse and emotional abuse and the sexual abuse, 1,000 per children. Next. The most common places where this is affected in the entire limb, appendicular or the axial skeleton. Next. The mechanism is this, that they hold the baby like this and shake to stop the crying. So what will happen? this is what the whiplash or the crushing causing the rib fractures. Next. One small video of 1 minute, this is what they is, see, this is what they will do. They wanted to stop the cry, main cry, and then when they shake the baby like this, what will happen? The intracranial vessels will go in for a hemorrhage. Breach in the vessels will cause the hemorrhage, intracranial hemorrhage, and that will spread into the subarachnoid space or the retinal hemorrhages. Next. So the history is very important. Delayed visit to the emergency room and unconvincing explanation, unexplained unconsciousness, emotional trauma. These are all the very, very crucial history to diagnose this, and skin burns, bruises, laceration, hematomas. Next. So the role of any teamwork, it is a teamwork, one is awareness, existence of a child abuse, and detection of occult non-accidental injury, and discrepancy between the history and the severity of the fracture and the age of fracture, and documenting child abuse. The legal obligation to report suspected child abuse and usually to referring physician. Next. So fractures commonly will be the bucket handle fracture, the ribs, as I showed you, that holding the baby itself, that will cause the crush, and the spinous process sternum and the occipital impression fractures. So skeletal trauma, like distal femur, distal humerus. So when your suspicion is there and you do a skeletal survey, and the fractures in the different stages of healing will be observed in that fracture. Next. So that is the corner fracture. That is classical for this battered baby child. Next. And also diaphyseal fracture, which is non-specific. No history of trauma, nothing will be there. That is due to the abuse of the child. Next. And also bucket angle fracture like this, and the avulse to bony fragment will be seen separately in X-ray. Next. And the rib fracture. See, classically it will be on the posterior aspect and the anterior aspect, and that it will cause this fracture. So you should have a suspicion. When there is a multiple fracture or one or two fractures are there, then you have a suspicion this could be a battered baby child. Next. And that is the rib fracture with a callus formation. Next. And the healing. So fracture healing, diaphyseal fracture. Next. And the skull fracture also is possible, and I told you the mechanism which will cause the subarachnoid hemorrhage or the subdural hemorrhages. Next. And the pattern of skull fracture that suggests child abuse are. Next. Eggshell fractures. Next. Occipital impression fractures. Next. Fracture crossing the sutures. These are all will suggest it is not due to the accidental fall, it is due to child abuse. Next. So that is the fracture, very resistant to trauma. So any fracture that is inconsistent with the history should raise the possibility of a non-accidental injury. Next. And a subdural hematoma. And also you can do an ultrasound also. Neonatal ultrasound that neurosonogram also will pick up the subdural hematoma. Once it is there, then you can do a CT scan or MRI scan. Next. And a CT finding will be subdural hemorrhage, subarachnoid hemorrhage, epidural hemorrhage, or a cerebral edema, acute cerebral contusions. These are all possible in the battered baby child. Next. MR also can be done. And that leaves some marks on the brain. Next. Visceral injury. Yes, not only the head, neck and the chest, visceral injuries also is possible. Next. This is what? A trauma to the liver, pancreas or the intestinal organs. Next. So when you do a CT scan, you can see the lacerations of the liver and also the laceration of the pancreas. Next. Retinal hemorrhage. Yes. Cervical compression also possible because of the violent movement of the baby. Next. So when you suspect, we can do this skeletal radiological survey to identify the fracture, various phases of healing of the bone. Next. Differential diagnosis. Accidental injury, main thing is the history is clear, consistent, and reflect the forces described, and no unexplained skeletal injuries are identified if it is an accidental injury. You see that fracture, posterior aspect of the fracture and displacement is there. This baby has fallen from a cot. Fracture, clavicle also is there. Next. Another one is a coagulopathy, hemophilia, hypothrombocytopenia causing vitamin K deficiency. These are also suggest, also will have the fracture. You have to differentiate this one by doing a blood test. Next. Osteogenesis imperfecta, congenital or the infant or TADA one. Generalized osteoporosis will be there with a callus formation. Next. Metaphyseal dysplasia. This is also one of the differential diagnoses for the battered baby child. Next. Thank you very much.
Sir, one question, sir. Sir, do you have any statistics of Tamil Nadu? In Tamil Nadu, we have a battered baby child.
No, it is rampant, sir, but we have not taken any statistics.
Indian statistics, you don't have any of the Indian statistics.
Yes,
also.
Yes,
so
yes,
they are
yes.
The foreign statistics.
Yes, yes. Okay,
sir,
yes.
Recently I came across, I read a news about the battered baby.
Yes.
In UK or the USA. That's one thing that's convicted.
Yes, so we don't have statistics. We are working for that one. Pediatric department and radiology department, we are working for that. Once it has come, I will inform. We are working for that.
In your experience, have you come across how many cases of battered baby inside?
Nearly 300 to 400 cases, sir. It has been reported.
From your experience, sir.
Yes, yes. My college led casualty cases have come, history, and it's like this. We have diagnosed. Non-accidental injury cases.
Thank you, sir. Very good, sir.
Thank you.
I request Dr. Maria, past president, to come and hand over the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Mike Prasanna.